Hey YouTube, I'm Tristan from Smart Home Point. Do you like my scarf? I knitted it myself. No, I'm joking. This is the smart LED light strip that I showed in another video that I created myself. The reason I created it myself is I'm going to be installing this in my kitchen, which I'm going to show in this video. But I've actually got a dishwasher in the way, in the middle of my run, and I didn't want to go out and buy loads of different LED light strips and loads of connectors to actually join things together. So I thought it'd be a lot easier to create my own ZigBee light strip. And as I mentioned, I've got a previous video on this, which you can check out. But in today's video, I wanted to show off this light strip more, show how I'm going to install it in my kitchen, and also discuss whether it's more useful to actually run LED light strips as they are, with just the backing tape on them and install them directly, or whether to run them in a diffuser channel. Now, a diffuser channel is quite useful because it actually spreads out or diffuses the light, and as a result, you don't get these individual light bumps or hotspot type effect. It helps a diffuser, basically helps spread that out. It also helps cool the LED channel as well, because it basically the diffuser acts as a heatsink. So I wanted to show this all off in this video. Let's take a look. Okay, so first thing I done was actually measure up and then cut my diffusers. And basically to install these, you want to have this bracket. You can see there, you need to actually screw this into the bottom of your kitchen cabinets in my case, which basically involves planking on the floor and using a really small screwdriver.
Wouldn't recommend.
No, it's really annoying to do. Right, also if you've got any corners, you need to make sure that you actually cut them accordingly so that you can actually run the LED light strip around that corner, which is like this. It's a bit sloppy, doesn't look that good, but it does the job.
Title of your sex tape.
Okay, now here I actually have run all my LED light strip. You can see it's behind my dishwasher that I've had to pull out, and I'm powering it just from a power strip on that. And before I push my dishwasher back in, I want to make sure everything works. And so what I'll do is just turn on the switch. And you can see there, the LED light strips light up, which is great. So I'll keep them on while pushing the dishwasher back, just to make sure that, you know, there's no loose connection or anything like that. There we are. So you can see now that I've actually pushed the dishwasher back, and crucially I've got slack on my LED light strip, so I can run them into the diffuser channel with no issue whatsoever. So actually having slack and making sure you've got slack is really important here. Okay, so in terms of actually running them into the aluminium channel, take off the backing tape, it makes it a bit easier, and then literally just position. As you can see here, I'm just literally positioning the LED light strip all the way along. And that's there. Make sure it's got a nice stick. Make sure it's stuck down nice, that is. Okay, brilliant. And once that's all stuck down and you're happy with it, you can now actually put the cover on it, and this diffuses the light. You can almost see the light changing now. Well, not at the moment because I'm messing around with something. There we are, let's carry on. Right, and that diffuses the light a lot better now that that cover's actually on it. Okay, there we are. And please ignore the dust, sorry about that. Brilliant. Right, so that's all done. So if I just show you that now, you can actually see it in the strip there. You can actually see the dotted effect, the hot spots, but they are a lot better with the diffuser channel than if you didn't run that at all. So that's the finished effect there. Right, now in terms of the actual hotspot effect, the left-hand side actually has the covers on them, the diffuser covers, the right-hand side does not, and you can see the dotted effect a lot more prominent here, so I just wanted to show this off because it's quite important to show, so you can see all those individual hotspots, compared to on the left-hand side where you just don't have that. So the overall effect is a lot nicer with a diffuser channel and obviously with the cover on. And that's the final effect. There we are. So I'm quite happy with how it's turned out. As you can see, it's a really nice effect. A diffuse channel, there's no cables anywhere. It's a custom run. It's all controllable via ZigBee, via my Philips Hue app, or an Amazon Echo device really easily. And as you can see, it changes color. It dims down. It can be turned off. And it can be turned back on. So I'm really happy with how this is turned out. It's completely custom installed, and it looks really nice in my opinion. If you like this video, please click the thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.